Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. The 2020 college football season came to an end last week when Alabama took down Ohio State in the national championship. That, of course, now means we have a very long offseason ahead of us. But we're not entirely done with the 2020 season quite yet. Today, we're going to take a look at some of the most surprising teams from this past season, surprising teams that made this 2020 season so special, so insane, so unpredictable, one of the best seasons in college football history. So today, we're going to take a look at what we believe to be the biggest surprises, our top seven surprise teams up here. They're not ranked in any order. They're not ranked in any specific order, but these are the teams that we thought caught the nation by surprise. And if there's a team up here that you think should be, leave that down in the comments below. We want to hear from you, your thoughts on our seven, and your thoughts as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at our first team up here. It's Indiana. And I think you could make a case between Coastal Carolina and Indiana as being the top two surprises in college football this past season. You look at the Hoosiers and what Tom Allen did and what was a wild year for the Big Ten as a whole. They didn't start their season until near the end of October. So much uncertainty if they were really going to play. The Hoosiers, you know, we knew we're going to have a decent year. We said was going to have one of the best teams in program history, but we didn't know if they could live up to it. And I would say they did. 6-2 in 2020. They rose as high as number 9 in the rankings. They were 9th when they fell to Ohio State in Columbus, falling 42-35. Heck of a battle against the Buckeyes, who of course played in the national championship game. They were number 11 in the Outback Bowl when they played Ole Miss, a game they lost. That was their second loss of the season. So Indiana still searching for their first bowl win since 1991, but I do believe they would have won the Outback Bowl had they not lost their quarterback Michael Penix earlier in the year. So you have him. I think they beat Ole Miss. They only fell to the Rebels 26-20, but they finished as a top 15 team. Guys, this team has so much potential, and they could be due for a huge year in 2021. Right now, I still think they could be the biggest threat to Ohio State in the Big Ten East going into next season. A lot of that is because of the strength of their defense and the culture that Tom Allen has instilled in Bloomington. So an unbelievable year for the Hoosiers. Sticking in the Big Ten, let's take a look at Rutgers. Now, I know what you're thinking. We've got two teams up here that have losing records, Rutgers and Arkansas. And we'll start with the Scarlet Knights. How are they a surprise team sitting at 3-6? Well, Rutgers greatly exceeded expectations in year one under Greg Schiano. Let's put this into perspective. Rutgers won three conference games. Remember, the Big Ten, all-conference slate this year. Three conference games in 2020. They won three Big Ten games between 2016 and 2019. 16, 17, 18, 19, four seasons, they won three total Big Ten conference games. They won three in one season in a year like this with a first-year head coach and Greg Schiano. They're a major surprise team. They opened the year with that 38-27 victory over Michigan State. And again, the Spartans are nothing to brag about, but that was a shocker. They were heavy favorites in that game, and Rutgers' defense showed up big to get that season-opening victory. They won at Purdue. They won at Maryland. They had three losses by one possession, including a three-overtime loss to Michigan. So they easily could have been a 6-3 team. Couple plays go their way, and Rutgers easily could have been a 6-3, 4-5, somewhere around there team. Schiano is exceeding expectations. He's rebuilding the program that he loves up in Piscataway, New Jersey. And I wholeheartedly believe that if he continues to recruit at the level that he is, if he continues to utilize the transfer portal, continues to instill that winning culture at Rutgers, one they have not had, probably since the last time he was there, that Rutgers could very well be a bowl team in 2021. Greatly exceed expectations. I think surprised a lot of people, not just in the Big Ten, but in the country in 2020. Last team in the Big Ten, got to go with Northwestern. Got to go with the team that won the West. And what a year for Pat Fitzgerald. I mean, he is arguably, always is, one of the most underrated coaches in college football. And he's starting to get the attention he deserves now. NFL teams were even looking at him over this offseason. But Northwestern going 3-9 in 2019. This year they finished 7-2. 7-2. Took Ohio State down to the wire. The final score of that game was 22-10 in the Big Ten championship game. Northwestern held the lead late into the third quarter. They just weren't able to hold on. A couple costly turnovers, a missed field goal, and the inability to stop Trey Sermon resulted in Northwestern losing the Big Ten championship. But they were in that game. The game was much closer than the score indicated. So they won the West, fought hard against Ohio State, annihilated Auburn in the Citrus Bowl, 35-19. And the biggest issue they had in 2019 was the inability to have a quarterback. Their offense was one of the worst in the country. Fitzgerald made the correct changes, switched up the coaching staff. They brought in Peyton Ramsey, the transfer quarterback from Indiana. The defense was, again, one of the top units in the country, and it resulted in a very historic year for the Wildcats. Again, their only losses to Ohio State and to Michigan State, a game they lost by 9 when the Wildcats were ranked as the 8th team in the country. So, Northwestern, future is still very bright as long as Pat Fitzgerald remains the man in Evanston. Right below Northwestern, Coastal Carolina. You can make an argument this is America's team. They were America's team, I think, for the majority of the season. 11-1 for the Chanticleers were just a few plays away from finishing the season undefeated. A perfect 12-0. But again, 11-1, nothing to frown about for a program that many people had no idea who they were going into 2020. But you look at what Jamie Chadwell has done. Again, he's another guy. As long as he's there, Coastal Carolina will remain a Sun Belt title contender. 11-0 before losing the Cure Bowl, 37-34 in overtime to Liberty. But a huge, huge win against BYU, I think, was the game that showed Coastal Carolina was for real. Chanticleers took down the Cougars 22-17. They were the 13th ranked team in the country, the Cougars were. That game, of course, happening on 2 days' notice and being stopped at the 1 yard line, arguably one of the top games of the season. Took down BYU, took down a ranked Louisiana team on the road, took down Kansas, a Power 5 team. This Coastal Carolina team is legit. This Coastal Carolina team is legit, and they shocked everybody. And every time people doubted them, I think they proved them wrong. They want to doubt it after the loss to Liberty? That's ridiculous. That's absolutely ridiculous, because Liberty, it's up here on our board, it's a dang good team. Coastal Carolina, as long as Jamie Chadwell's there, will be just fine. And let's remember, their star quarterback, Grayson McCall, was just a freshman this past season, meaning that 2021, Coastal Carolina could very well be the Sun Belt Conference favorites. Let's move over to the SEC, the second column here, Arkansas. We mentioned that earlier. How is Arkansas and Rutgers, two teams up here with losing records, how are they a surprise team? Arkansas was very similar to Rutgers in 2020. Rutgers had won 3 conference games between 2016 and 2019. Arkansas brought a 20-game SEC losing streak into 2020. First-year head coach in Sam Pittman trying to put out the dumpster fire that Chad Morris left behind for 2 years in Fayetteville comes in here and snaps that losing streak, snaps the 20-game SEC losing streak on the road at number 16 Mississippi State. Right then, Razorback fans would have been satisfied. Streak is over. We won on the road against a ranked team, one that had just annihilated LSU the week before. They're happy. We're good to go. But Pittman didn't stop there. Pittman did not stop there. They had an amazing defensive performance against Ole Miss. They beat Tennessee. They had 3 losses by 1 possession. The very questionable game at Auburn, where the refs absolutely took that game away from the Razorbacks. A 3-point loss to LSU, a 2-point loss to Missouri. Similar to Rutgers, a few plays go their way. The Razorbacks could have been a 500 team or very well could have been a 6-4 team. They should have at least had 4 wins up there. But Sam Pittman is building something in Fayetteville. Like Shiano, he's instilling a winning culture in Fayetteville, something that Razorback fans and something this Razorback program really haven't seen since maybe 2015, 2016, where they were mediocre under Brett Bielema. Arkansas is rounding the corner. 3 SEC wins in 1 year, arguably the toughest schedule in the country. They've got stability now. They've got momentum now. And this very well could be a bowl team, should be a bowl team in 2021. Last 2 teams up here on the big board, Liberty, real quick. What an amazing job Hugh Freeze has done with the Flames. You know, last year was great. Now, Liberty fans were pleased with last year. 8-5, they got their first bowl win in program history. They're good to go. Hugh Freeze did not stop there. They go 10-1 this year. Their only loss was by 1 point at North Carolina State, a team that ended up finishing, 8-4, 8-3, played Kentucky in their bowl game. 1 point at North Carolina State. They ended the year with a win against Coastal Carolina, the 12th ranked team in the country in that Cure Bowl. So ended the season with a lot of momentum. And a lot of it was thanks to Malik Willis. Malik Willis, the transfer quarterback from Auburn, was the key for this Liberty team this year. And he showed up and showed out and did his job. And with him being back, assuming he comes back for Liberty this upcoming season, the Flames very well could run the table again. Because they've shown, and Hugh Freeze has shown, they're not afraid to play anybody. Almost took down NC State. They went on the road and took down Virginia Tech. They went on the road and took down Syracuse. And then, of course, beat Coastal Carolina. This team, with this offense, can hang with anybody. It's about time you start watching out for the Flames. We knew they were going to be good this year, but I don't think anybody saw them being this good. And I think you can say the same thing about BYU sitting at 11-1. 11-1. We knew BYU was going to be decent. We knew they were going to be somewhat solid. But did anyone think at one point in time they were going to be a top 10 team? 11-1 on the year? I don't think so. Their only loss, remember guys, came at Coastal Carolina on 2 days' notice. The game was scheduled on Thursday. BYU flew all the way out there and played the game on Saturday. And that game came down to the final play, stopped at the 1 yard line. Major reason for BYU's success was Zach Wilson, throwing for over 3,600 yards and had 43 total touchdowns to just 3 interceptions. This breakout year for Zach Wilson solidified him as a first-round NFL draft pick when the draft rolls around in April. He was the major key to BYU's success. Many would say the weak schedule, but every time BYU had a tough game, they showed up and showed out. Annihilated Boise State, nearly beat Coastal Carolina, annihilated Navy in the season opener, and then annihilated Central Florida in the Boca Raton Bowl. That, to me, I think proved all the BYU doubters wrong. When you beat UCF 49-23 in their own backyard, pretty much, put up 655 yards of offense on the Knights, and held UCF to just 217 passing yards, well below their season average, that showed that BYU was legit. Did they deserve a shot at the playoff? Strength of schedule would say no. But they showed up and showed out when they had a tough opponent. This team was for real. Kalani Sitake did an amazing job in 2020. They're going to have to rebuild a little bit with so many losses, including Zach Wilson. But from now on, people are going to know not to underestimate the Cougars. So those are our top 7 surprise teams, guys. A few honorable mentions again. San Jose State. San Jose State, not up here on the big board, but an amazing year for them. Won the Mountain West Conference for the first time ever. Nearly had an undefeated season for the first time since 1939, but got annihilated by Ball State in their bowl game, 34-13. But an amazing year for Brent Brennan and the Spartans. Colorado, rough finish falling to Utah in the season finale and Texas in their bowl game. But the future looks very bright for Carl Durrell, making do with what he had in a very short season out in the Pac-12. Again, I didn't think that was a great hire. Proved me wrong. Hopefully he continues to prove me wrong going down the road. We can hopefully have a full normal season. And finally, Tulsa went undefeated in the American Athletic Conference until the conference championship game against Cincinnati. So when you look at it and you put it into perspective, their losses came at Oklahoma State in the season opener, only by 9 points. They lost to Cincinnati in the title game, losing on a game-winning field goal as time expired. They lost by 2 in their bowl game to Mississippi State, a game that ended with one of the worst, if not the worst, brawl I have ever seen in all of sports. A shame for both teams on that one. But again, an unbelievable job for Philip Montgomery, a guy that was on the hot seat coming in to 2020. He certainly took his name off of that by season's end. So there you have it, guys, your 2020 surprise teams. Again, let's hear from you. Who's up here that shouldn't be? Who's not up here that should be? Leave your comments and your thoughts and your suggestions in the comments below. We want to hear from you. We want to get your feedback. Again, these are surprise teams that weren't just one-hit wonders, guys. These are teams that are going to continue to grow and teams that you need to keep your eye on in 2021. I certainly think that everybody across the nation will be doing that. No one is going to underestimate these teams and overlook them again going into next season. So guys, thank you so much for watching us here at The Gridiron Expert on YouTube. Make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, and share our videos. Also, make sure to check out everything down in that description below. We've got exclusive GE merchandise. We have our Patreon account. We have our website, thegridironexpert.com. So many offers and so much college football content for you guys. It's not here on YouTube that you can access year-round. So make sure to go give that a look. And once again, as always, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time right here on The Gridiron Expert.